I had no idea there were all these great stories out there, so I took another one and another one. And the more children's books I did, the more I realized that was really what I'd always loved to do. When I was a kid, that's what I did. I read books and I drew pictures of what I saw in my head. So like when I read The Hobbit, I drew lots of hobbits and Gandalf and that kind of thing. And I realized I was drawing the same subject matter that I drew as a kid, with baseball players and pirates and knights and things like that. When I first began doing children's books, like when I did editorial work, my palette was a lot more muted and dark, and slowly but surely become more colorful, and I just like the colors better. But when I'm doing a book, I kind of think of it as like directing a little movie or something. So I try to make everything in the pictures reinforce the story in some way. And so color can do an awful lot with conveying emotion and mood and tone of the story. So, I mean, if you're doing a sad story, a lot of times bright colors aren't the way to go. The original, I made when I was a little kid, and then I saw it later that my mom had saved it, and I decided, you know, this could make a good children's book. I mean, it had this sort of gut appeal to the kid that was still, you know, the kid inside me still. And so, you know, the only words in it were No and David. So I felt, well, 32 pages of No and David, that's going to get a little monotonous. So I wanted to expand on the text. So I tried all sorts of different things, and what emerged was this idea of these timeless ways moms have of saying no. They've all, you know, my mom and my mom's mom and my mom's mom have always said, don't play with your food, things like that. At first I drew David more realistically, like I draw some of my other books, and it just sat there. It just didn't have any of the charm or energy of the original. So I went back to the original and I tried drawing more like a 5-year-old. And all of a sudden he just, you know, jumped off the page and started picking his nose. But all the things like the pointy teeth and the hair and his little round body and stuff, that's all from the original. The way the type is kind of scrawled, that's from the original. Whenever I got stuck on how to do anything, I went back to the original and said, well, you know, how did the 5-year-old do it? And so she's aware that I'm making these books, and you know, if we're reading one of mine, you know, we'll say, I'll start by Duck on a Bike by, and she'll say, by Daddy. And if we go into a bookstore, she's my little salesman. Here, buy this, my daddy made it. You know, it's kind of embarrassing. Oh, I hate lima beans. Okay. Yeah. And I think most kids do. That was actually the last thing that changed in that story. Originally, the cure was marshmallows, just because they're yummy. She just ate something because it was yummy, and it cured her. And my editor and I were discussing the ending, and we decided it would work better if we could come up with something that most people hated, but she liked. That would be a more effective ending for the story. So I thought, you know, lima beans, of course. Kids, you know, that's the international symbol of food hatred, is lima beans. And so I called my editor and I told her, and she said, well, why lima beans? And I go, because everybody hates them. And she said, they do? And it turned out that she'd always loved lima beans her whole life and had no idea that kids couldn't stand them. So she actually, she didn't believe me, so she had to call all sorts of, she took a poll around the office and called back and said, okay, you're right, everyone hates them. You know, a lot of a lot of people ask me for advice about unruly kids, and I'm not sure I can. I'm qualified to respond to that because I was an unruly kid. I think probably. Let me think about this. When I was in school, I mean, I was an unruly kid. I wasn't as bad as David, but I was a handful, and I never. You know, I never meant to be malicious or anything like that. I was just cracking jokes, you know. So I would say to just, if you got a kid like David, to just, you know, try to enjoy him as much as you can. And when he pushes it too far, send him out in the hall. That's how I was handled. And I think that did pretty well.
The Reading Rockets Meet the Author series is a production of WETA. Major funding for Reading Rockets comes from the United States Department of Education, Office of Special Education Programs. For more author interviews, recommended reading lists, and information about teaching kids to read, please visit us online at www.readingrockets.org.